Great Scott, I can't for the life of me figure out this ridiculous clock.
It appears to me that you're not from around these parts, my friend.
This is the land of Egypt. I just finished installing my new invention, the sundial!
I've gone back in time to the invention of the sundial. I've been tinkering with the clock myself. Any idea how a clock with gears works?
What on this flat world are you talking about?
Oh, well, how exactly have you been telling time in Egypt?
Well, now I plan to use the sundial. We've been using the sun, the stars, and the moon to tell time.
Primitive, but foolproof. As helpful as your information was, I still have yet to find out about the modern clock. Where's that portal thing I came here in?
You mean that fanciful swirly thing over yonder?
Oh, yes! Thank you, sir, and have a lovely day.
Toodaloo!
John, stranger! What on earth are you frolicking my workshop for?
Oh, I've just been time traveling. Can I ask you what this bowl is for?
This is my personal water clock. It is invented by the Chinese. It's quite old, not very up to date, but it works all right. It is a small hole that lets out water.
Fascinating. What kind of clock are you working on right now?
A spring power clock. A weighted clock was invented by my rival, and I strived to create a more accurate and lightweight clock.
That's great, but I haven't seen any springs or weight in my timepiece. I guess I'll just have to continue time traveling to find the right clock.
Now go and get out of my face.
What on earth are you doing here now?
Well, I've been on an amazing time-traveling adventure looking for information about clocks. You don't happen to know anything about them, do you?
Well, Landlubber, it just so happens that I, the great Captain Anders Dingelstein, have been holding a contest to find someone who can invent a new clock that can navigate the seas, even though because of that blasted pendulum swaying in the waves of the ocean.
Pendulum? What's that?
Oh, that's a clock that uses a swaying stick thing to tell time. But the waves have made those kind of clocks useless, so the Brits have been trying to invent a new kind of clock that can work on the high seas. And they have just found that right one. See, a marine chronometer has been invented, and I think that might just do the trick.
Ah, well, thank you, but you've been little help. I bid you good tidings in your sailings.
Arrgh, little help? Tell that to my pistol, mate.
Oi, chap! What on this rotating chunk of junk are you doing in my laboratory? I've been well on my way to inventing the newest time-telling device, the digital clock.
Oh, do tell. What have you accomplished?
Well, with the invention of digital screens, circuitry, and easily accessible electricity, I've created a program system that displays time with digits.
Ah, I certainly do see a lot about this today. It's incorporated in phones and a lot of other electronic devices.
Hey, where are you from anyways?
I'm just a figment of your imagination. Sir, what large contraption do you have here?
You, my comrade, are about to experience the most innovative discovery ever. The use of molecules on an atomic level to tell the time.
Why don't we just use a digital clock?
Well, even digital clocks aren't exact. The clock is off by only a fraction of a second.
Ridiculous, but fascinating. Any idea when a clock like that was invented?
You may want to try 1957. Some of today's first uses of electronic clocks.
Well, thanks. I'll see you later.
What?
Hello, sir. What can I help?
Hi. Is this 1957?
Yes, it is 1957.
Are you inventing the battery-powered clock?
It just so happens I am. This battery here controls the gears, which move the minute hand on the clock, as you can see here. It's not entirely my design, but I plan to mass produce it in the future.
Oh, now I see what I'm missing. Thanks, mister. I really appreciate it.
Ah, happy to help.
Ah, you again! Who are you, and when am I?
Congratulations, soldier, for finding the important turning points in history concerning times and clocks. You found several turning points. Clocks and the ability to tell time have been used militantly and navally to help find location for naval purposes and to time attacks for just all militant purposes in general. Napoleon, a good friend of mine, would use watches, pocket watches, and also wrist watches when they came available to time his attacks, and that was very useful for him. And without those, he might not have been as successful as he was with almost dominating the entire world. Also, scientists used hourglasses to conduct experiments, which has thus furthered our civilization. That is also a turning point. Another turning point that you didn't know about is clocks have changed how we do our everyday life. It just changed to give people more purpose. It used to be sun up, you'd start working, sun down, you'd stop. Now we can work forever, we can plan out when we're going to do things, all because of the wonderful invention we call the clock. Also, in ancient times, churches used to be the only people with clocks. And when the clock struck at a certain time, it would tell you when you were going to have prayers, meals, and when you're going to come to church. If you didn't come to church, the preacher would come by and be like, "Why didn't you come to church? The clock rang," and then you'd have no excuse. So it pretty much controlled your entire life. The church could control your life with a clock. That is also a very important turning point. Excuse my stuttering. Another turning point is when, after the American Revolution, there wasn't much metal in America for clocks you made with, and since the British were blockading us by sea from getting resources from other countries in Europe, we were not able to make clocks. We made wooden clocks, which were not as accurate as metal clocks. But after the War of 1812, when we defeated the British and they left our lands and stopped blockading us, we were able to make metal clocks and do thus freely. I bid you farewell as the General of Time.
Well, thank you. I didn't know I did so much. Now I gotta go fix my clock. Oh, I was only missing the battery. Let me just place it here, and voila! My clock is in perfect order. Thanks, guys.
Excuse me, baby.